dear students, welcome back to social science class. See children, in previous class, we are discussing civics part in first lesson, our defense courses. Today, we will continue the lesson. In previous class, we are discussing first division of our defense courses, that is Indian Army. Today, we are going to discuss what are the functions performed by our Indian Army. Understand? First division of our defense forces, that is Indian Army. Today we are going to discuss which are the functions are performed by Indian Army. Understand children? See, first functions of our Indian Army. The army as the rendering
landslides and
word humanitarian. Understand? Second word. Second functions of our Indian army, that is the land army, apart from being technically advanced. Understand? See, the army apart from service or to protection the eyelids, and coastal lines. Coastal lines. Understand? Why we need Indian Navy or Navy Force? Indian Navy service or services are necessary to protection the islands. Islands and also coastal lines. Understand? It means for Indian Navy give the protection to the islands of our country and coastal lines of our country. So we need the Indian Navy. Understand? Understand, children? See, Indian Navy services are necessary to protection the islands of our country and also coastal lines of our country. So we need the Indian Navy. Understand? See. And also the Indian Navy is the sixth largest of the world. The Indian Navy is the sixth largest in the world. Very important. Now I give the introduction about the Indian Navy. See, the Indian Navy is the sixth largest in the world. And also the service chief. The Indian Navy service chief is called sea admiral. Very important. Admiral, you already know that one. Indian Army service chief is called as general. Like that, Indian Navy service chief is called admiral. Understand? Very important. How to remember? See, next, the headquarters is located. The Indian Navy headquarters. The Indian Navy headquarters is in New Delhi. Is it New Delhi? Very important. Head office or headquarters is located in New Delhi. Indian Navy headquarters became formed in New Delhi. Understand? Very important. And also Indian Army headquarters also is located is New Delhi. Like that, Indian Navy headquarters also is in New Delhi. Understand, children? Very important. This is the introduction about the Indian Navy. Indian Navy services are necessary to protection the islands and coastal lines. The Indian Navy is the sixth largest in the world. The Indian Navy service chief is called admiral. The Indian Navy headquarters is in New Delhi. Understand? Next. The Indian Navy consists of advanced missiles, ships and submarines. See? The Indian Navy consists consist advancing, mizzen, shifts and submarines. Understand? Indian Navy has mizzen, shifts and submarines. Understand? Mizzen ship means shipani navkegalu. Mizzen ship. We say in Kannada, Shipani Navkegalu. Understand? Shipani Adagugalu. Understand? What? Mizzen ships means Shipani Adagugalanna Hondide. Yavudu? Indian Navy. See, Indian Navy consists advanced mizzen ships and submarines. Which are the important ships we can find in the Indian Navy? See here, among them, INS this is one of the mizzen ships belongs to Indian Navy. Understand? See, the Indian Navy consists advanced mizzen ships and submarines. Among them, such as INS Vibhuti. We have to pronunciation letter INS Vibhuti. What is the full form is INS? Indian Navy ship or ships. Understand? What is the full form of INS? INS full form is Indian Navy ships. See here, among them INS Vibhuti and another one is there, that is INS Godavari. INS Godavari. These are all important and advanced mizzen ships is in Indian Navy. Understand? Which are the advanced mizzen ships? Name them is INS Vibhuti. It was the name of mizzen ships, advanced mizzen ships. And second one is INS Godavari. These two also very, very important advanced mizzen ships we can find in Indian Navy. And also another also prominent means both are also very prominent. Prominent means you already know that one. Important. Prominent means important. INS Vibhuti and INS Godavari are very important in Indian Navy. And other also we can find in Indian Navy. Apart them, INS Virat, INS Virat, and next INS Vikramaditya, INS INS Vikramaditya, and as well equipped with the fighter aircraft. Understand? See, among them INS Vibhuti, INS Godavari is very, very prominent in Indian Navy. Apart them, other mizzen ships also is there. Example, INS Virat and INS Vikramaditya, and also and also we can form the when A cross. Understand? We can form and also we can form the well equipped A cross also. In what our Indian Navy and also Indian Navy is called very very important. Bharatiya Vayu Padai. Indian Air Force is in Canada. Bharatiya Vayu Padai. This is the third division of our Indian Force. See, the Indian Air Force is the fifth biggest in the world. The Indian Air Force is the fifth biggest largest sea, biggest in the world. In the world, very, very important. Next, the Indian Air Force chief is called the Indian Air Force. Air Force chief. Chief is colored marshal. Colored what? Marshal. See, the Indian Air Force chief is called what? Marshal. Understand? Indian Army Force chief is called general. Indian Navy Service chief is called admiral. And Indian Air Force chief is called marshal. Very, very important. Now to remember. And also, this headquarters is located the headquarters situated at New Delhi. Understand, children? The headquarters of Indian Air Force is situated at New Delhi. And also, see, for the administrative convenience, the Indian Air Force is divided into 5 commanding stations. Very, very important. See, for administration, convenience, the Indian Navy Force as being divided into 5 commanding stations. Understand? See here, for administration purpose or convenience. Understand? The Indian Air Force administration convenience or purpose, the Indian Navy Force has been divided into 5 commanding stations in India. Which are they means? First one is the command stations at Bangalore. First one, the command station Third one is Dindigul. Understand? Dindigul is located in Tamil Nadu. Understand? For administration purpose or convenience, the Indian Navy Force has been divided into 5 command divisions in India. First one is the command station at Bengaluru. Second one is the command station at Hyderabad. And command station at Dindigul is located in Tamil Nadu. These are all the very, very important command stations in India. And also, as a result of advancement of latest technology, it is equipped with the fighter aircrafts and face any emergency. Understand? And also, the Indian Air Force has its own technical aircrafts. And also they face the so many challenges. Indian Air Force also face the so many challenges. Understand children? These are all the information about the Indian Air Force. Understand? Indian Air Force is the third division of our defense forces. Understand children? Very, very important how to remember 3 divisions of our defense forces. See, our Air Force is equipped with the latest fighter aircrafts like Jaguar. The Air Force comprises 1,00,000 airmen and 1,330 fighter aircrafts, and strength of the Air Force is a matter of pride to the country. Indian Air Force. Understand? Very, very important. We have to remember our Air Force is equipped the latest fighter aircrafts. Its name is Jaguar. Understand? Latest fighter aircrafts is called Jaguar. And also Air Force comprises how many airmen? Means 1,00,000 airmen we can fight in our Indian Air Force. And also 1,330 fighters aircrafts we can find in our Indian Air Force. And the strength of our Air Force, how to pride as a citizen, as a countryman. These are all the information about the Indian Air Force. Understand children? Very, very important. Next, we will discuss other operational force. Operational defense forces. We say in Kannada, Karyacharane Rakshana Padegalu. See here. Rakshana Rakshana Padegalu. See, operational defense forces. We can call the main divisions of our with the main fighting force.
See, during the example, during the target
The dead border security force fought with the jointly with the army. Understand? Fought with jointly army. Understand? See here. Give the help of a border security force when we use example during the parking operation. That time border security force fought with the jointly our defense forces. Understand? Very important. And also the in peak of I mountain where is the peak of I mountain. Understand? See, and duty until death is the slogan of the BSF, and death slogan is the BSF. Very important. Very important slogan. This is the second branch of operational defense forces, border road organizations. See, the border road organizations open and close the entries to the army to enable armed operations instantly. Understand? What is the main duty of border road organization? Open and close the entries in the border. Understand? Open and closed entries to the army. Indian army. You have to remember. Opened and closed the entries to the Indian army to enable armed operations. To enable the operations. Understand? That time closed and opened the entries. That is the very important duty of border road organizations. See here. Closing and opening entries to Indian army. enable the operations. This is the important duty of border road organizations. See here, it also coordinates the important works like construction of the roads, bridges and railway lines, and also it must incorporate or coordinate with the important works. See here, not only this work and also coordinate with other works. Which are the other works? Means to construct the roads, bridge, and drainages in border area. Understand? See, to coordinate in other works such as are like that, construction roads, construction bridges, and also construction drainages in the border area. That time also border road organization will the coordinate with other work. Understand? It means what border road organization performing or important doing two work. One is closed and open entries to Indian Army to enable the operations. Understand? And coordinate with other works such as construction the roads, construction the bridges, and construction the drainages. That time also our border road organization need to coordinate with other work also. This is the second operational defense forces in our country, that is border road organization. And third one is the coastal guards. The coastal guards. See, this is the paramilitary force. What? This is the paramilitary force. It is the coastal also. This is the paramilitary force. See, its head office is situated in New Delhi. Understand? See, this is the head office is situated in New Delhi, and also the its major responsibility is to protect the coastal borders of the country. What is the main or major function or work important responsibility? The major responsibility. The major responsibility is to protect the coastal areas of the country. Understand, children? Give the concentration about the class. The coastal guards is one of the operational defense forces. Understand? This is the paramilitary force. The coastal guards also known as paramilitary force. This is the head office is situated in New Delhi. The major responsibility is to the protect the coastal areas of the country. Understand, children? It also undertakes the humanitarian service. Understand? It also the coastal guards also give the or display the humanitarian services during the natural calamities. During the natural calamities, our coastal guards give the humanitarian service to our countrymen and our citizens. Which are the calamities means wind, tsunami and also cyclone. Understand? See here, the coastal guards give the humanitarian services or show the humanitarian services. When they will show the humanitarian service to our citizen means in the natural calamities, natural disasters. Which are natural disasters means wind and tsunami and also cyclone. That time the coastal guard show the humanitarian service. It is also very very prominent responsibility of coastal guards or paramilitary force. Understand? And also include the preventing institutions, smuggling and such others. Very very important. See here. Responsibility of military force and also the preventing activities. smuggling activities and also institutions. And also institutions and also such other activity and such other activities. Understand children? See what are the main responsibilities of the coastal guards. Means see the coastal guards known as paramilitary force undertake humanitarian service during the natural calamities such as earthquake, tsunami and cyclones is the main responsibility of the our coastal guards. And next one is preventing the smuggling activities in coastal area and institutions and also such other activities are preventing. Preventing is controlling by the our coastal guards or paramilitary force. These are the responsibilities of our the coastal guards or paramilitary services or force. Next, we will discuss next operational defense forces in our country. That is what the operational defense forces. Central Industrial Security Forces. Central Industry Central Industries Security Security Force. This is also one of the operational defense forces of our country. See, this is the biggest industrial security force in the world. Central Industrial Security Force is the biggest industries security force in India. Understand children? Is the biggest industry security force in India. See here, there are 120,000 soldiers are enrolled here. See here, 128,000 soldiers are there in the Central Industries Security Force. How many soldiers are there? 120,000 soldiers are there here. And as it's providing the security to over the 300 government and private industrial installations and the laboratories in the India. In India. It means power stations. We they are here. our communities. First one is airport, second one is harbors, and third one is vegetation and also historical sites and also nuclear power stations. These are all sector give the protection, central industries, security force. Understand? C is the biggest industry security force in India. And how many soldiers are there is here 128,000 soldiers are there and give the protection up to 300 government and also private industry installations and also laboratories in the India. And also it give the protection to the airport, give the protection to the airport harbors. Harbors means ship landing area is called harbor. Understand? Harbors and also railway stations, historical sites and also nuclear power stations give the protection in our country. Understand? These are all the operational defense forces in our country. Are you understand today class? Okay children, next